cameraman today.
That's almost a hard going to run that on that small cable, and see it.
Thank you.
in Baltimore, dinner in the diner, coffee could be finer, than to have the ham and eggs in Carolina. When you hear the whistle blow and eight to the bar, then you know that Tennessee is not very far. Shovel all the coal in, gotta keep it rolling. We'll go Chattanooga, there you are. Oh, there's gonna be a certain party at the station on Saturday night. I used to call Funny Face. She's gonna cry until I tell her that I'll never, never roam. So Chattanooga, choo-choo, won't you choo-choo me home? Chattanooga, let me call you sweetheart, I'm in love with you. Let me hear you whisper that you love me too.
They've been rewritten. The song is a barbershop melody, so we'll give you a couple of our 60s numbers.
Under the boardwalk,
out of the sun, We'll be having some fun. People walking above. We'll be falling in love. Boardwalk, boardwalk. Now at the park, the gentle sound of the carousel. You could almost taste the hot dogs and French fries by the shell. Under the boardwalk, down by the sea, yeah. On a blanket with my baby is where I'll be.
Under the boardwalk,
out of the sun, we'll be having some fun.
The boardwalk,
people walking above.
Under the boardwalk,
we'll be falling in love. Boardwalk, boardwalk.
We're saying bye.
Indicate precisely what you mean to say. You're yours sincerely, wasting away. Give me your answer, fill in a form, I'm forevermore. Will you still need me? Will you still feed me? When I'm 64, when I'm 64.
Used to load freight cars down here and from the kennel company.
know where he went to, but right. But I do want to.
Number 10, Trolley. There's a lot that I could say about this project, but because I like you folks, I'm not going to. I am going to thank a lot of the people that helped to make this, were responsible for this day happening. Certainly, Sam Bartlett is a key person that you may not have heard of, but all this electrical wiring that you see up here, and maybe the transformers and rectifiers that you didn't see are thanks to Sam, and he's really pulled it all together, as well as being very responsible for a lot of the brakes and electrical. There's a man that has driven me crazy for the last 4 years. I was crazy before I started, but I've gotten more crazy. But Bruce Stain is really the mad genius who's made the mechanical electrical things work on the car and has put a lot of time into it and has made this day possible. And Fred Perry, who drove from St. Louis on Thursday to help with the wiring. Joe Pagano is somebody that I'd like to thank. Joe is really the one who has sort of taken us from the times of no funding to the times of funding, and is very responsible for the condition of these windows and things. And I hope what we're going to have happen here is Ross Adinho is going to be giving a little talk, and Senator Rosenberg is here, and I'm hoping it's going to say a couple of kind words. We're going to have an inaugural run with our honored guests, as well as our inaugural pass holders, and then we're going to be offering rides to all of you, assuming our conductor and motorman make it happen. But in any case, I wanted to make sure I thank Joseph Pagano, and I want to thank Michael Cole, because Michael Cole is very responsible for all the paint that you see in here, and I want you to take a special look at the woodwork in the car when you go inside. I've been very proud to be associated with this project for 8 years now, and it's been a long process. I think it was worthwhile. I hope the community of Shelburne Falls appreciates what this car represents to it, not only as a historical heirloom, but also as a vehicle transportation in the future, hopefully from parking here in the yard down to the village area, providing a transportation service to the village that it so finally served starting back in 1896. Without further ado, I'd like to ask Senator Rosenberg to come up and...
Thank you. I just want to offer congratulations to everybody who had a hand in making this a reality. I shouldn't call it the pleasure. I was in it when it was a chicken coop. And worrying about whether, if I took another step, I was going to fall through the bottom. But there were people who had a vision. They saw this looking like this when it was actually looking like that. And those people deserve an awful lot of credit. This is a piece of Americana brought back to life and will be another enhancement in the ever-increasing number of things that will draw people to come up here and visit, see our way of life here, and then hopefully leave a few dollars and then go home. And a lot of dollars, and then hopefully they'll like it enough that they'll come back again and visit us some more. But it's a wonderful piece of work and a great beginning to this Trolley Museum, and congratulations to everyone who had a hand in it, state and federal government funding, and the people who did all of the labor here and had the dream, and here it is coming through. Thank you.
He's around here for the funding, and he's been very responsible for the funding coming into this project, and so I'm really glad to have him. I think the lesson here today is for the young people, that if you believe in something and you stick with it long enough, it will happen. I had the opportunity to have lunch with Tony, and he said he started about 8 years ago. And I said, how old is your daughter? And he said, 9. So this young woman's almost her entire life, this gentleman has devoted his life so this could happen. And there's been bumps in the road. We've had a few. A couple of times we've had them in my office, you know, when we're dealing with the taxpayers' money, we kind of get very, very careful where it goes. But I told him we needed to bring pictures of this back, because as the senator knows, where the money comes from is from the east, but where we need to spend it is in the west. And there you go. This is a perfect example. One other thing I want to say is, and I admitted it to Tony, when the enhancement program got going, people like myself who devoted most of our lives to working on highways were a little jealous that highway money was going to be spent for something other than a highway. And when somebody said they wanted to do a lighthouse and a trolley and an arch bridge and many other enhancements, people like myself, who, again, devoted a lot of time and energy to doing highway, said, why? Ladies and gentlemen, this is why, right here. And I congratulate each and every one of you for teaching those of us who are in the middle age group, so we can teach the younger people that this is what it's all about. We need to remember and to be able to look to the past so we can go to the future. Thank you very much. Tony, great job. We're almost ready to start here. There's a couple of other people I'd like to mention in this process that helped here quite a bit. One is the electric company. Many people don't know that. We blew out our line on Thursday night. They came in yesterday and relayed the wire from here to there. And so one of the reasons we're going to be running today is because of the electric company. Another key issue with this car has had to do with brakes. We really weren't able to stop until about 8 o'clock this morning. Thanks to this man over here, Ed Stowe, who brought our brake handle for us and put it on the shaft. And last but not least, I'd like to thank a variety of touch-up people, clean-up varnishers and polishers, Christine Kilgore, Martha and Sylvia Davenport. Now, without further ado, our electronic engineer is going to raise the pole, and Miss Trolley is going to release the car for service. Go ahead.
You're going to go on it right now, honey.
What?
Where are your conductors? You guys bring in on?
Nate, the conductor's ready.
Oh.
All right.
Don't fly.
Let them fly.
Maybe
Maybe somebody can come up with a conductor's bell and then we'll ask them.
There you go.
Sorry, we went someplace last night and there's a damn parrot in there. And he was making a noise so you swear the telephone was ringing.
Oh no.
I said to the guy, your phone's ringing. He went and hit the phone. And he had to come outside.
On a playhouse for the kids as well.
Yeah.
Of course, fortunately, the farmer took pretty good care of it. You know what?
Thank you.